Satya Nadella.
Hi, I'm here with Nick from Microsoft Research and Robin, who's a teacher who's working with us on CodeJumper. CodeJumper is a tool that teaches programming to anyone with visual impairment, blindness, or low sight. So Nick and Robin, you want to tell us a little bit about CodeJumper?
Absolutely. CodeJumper is the physical programming language that we created to teach children ages 7 through 11 the basis of programming and computational thinking. And the idea is that children can use these physical pods, connect them together in lots of different ways, manipulate the dials to create programs. And when you run those programs, you hear some sound, whether it's musical notes or a story that gets played out.
That's fantastic. And as a teacher, Robin, what do you make of this?
I think CodeJumper is fantastic. What's really great, it allows my students to participate fully in the experience because it's not only visual, but we have auditory as well as a hands-on experience. Many of the programs that are out there for beginning coding are highly visual, and for students who are blind visually impaired, they can't get a full experience. And so with CodeJumper, they can really engage because they have the opportunity to just be fully with their peers.
That's fantastic. So shall we program?
Let's do it. Let's start with a simple program just to read out a sequence of numbers. So I'm going to take a play command pod that just reads out a number. I'm going to connect that.
To a larger
I'm
pod.
Going to follow it by a second one.
Two small pods.
So now we've got a sequence of two. If I hit play, we'll hear.
Perhaps the larger pod.
Two.
That's great. So can we now sort of do other data structures? Let's just do a loop or something?
Sure, that's it. So rather than just playing through the individual notes, what we could do is let's take this one, just one, and then we'll put it inside of a loop.
Another small pod.
So this one will happen a lot of times. Now, I connect that
to the larger pod.
And then I need to add a statement to say every time that you go through a loop, go up by one, because once you count up.
Attaches a small piece.
And then let me just make sure that
and can change the variable too?
Yeah, we can change the variable to start from one or whatever number we want, and then.
So our sequence had two commands. So with the loop pod, we turn the dial to determine how many times it loops around. So that was two, so I'm going to turn it to two.
A yellow dial.
Two.
Oh, that's awesome.
Cool. So now if I do it, we see.
This is the larger pod.
Two.
And we could turn it to make three, four, any number of times that we want.
Okay, that's fantastic. What else can we do?
Okay, so this is cool. We can take the exact same program that we just wrote, but rather than using numbers, let's use musical notes instead. So I'm going to plug it in here.
Connects to a different jack on the larger pod.
I'm going to hit play.
Oh, so it's not counting, it's playing music now.
It's playing music, two notes, one higher than the next.
What are the goals for this project?
Through our partnership with the American Printing House for the Blind, we're hoping to get CodeJumper into the hands of the children that can really benefit from it. 75% of people who are blind or have low vision are unemployed, and an even greater number is underemployed. So we're hoping that with tools like CodeJumper that can teach the basics of coding at an early age, we might be able to change that number in the future.
Really, it's that I can attitude from the very beginning, because we want the kids to get coding in their hands when they're young. And with when the students go through the CodeJumper curriculum, they then have the confidence to move on to text-based coding, and who knows, maybe a career in computer science down the road.
Oh, that's wonderful. And where can people go to learn more about this?
To learn more about CodeJumper, you go to CodeJumper.com, and all the information you need is right there.
Thank you so much, Robin and Nick. It's fantastic to see this all come to life, and I know this is going to be not only fantastic for anyone with low sight or blindness, but everyone who wants to be able to learn with physical input and yet have computational thinking.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
They shake hands. Microsoft.